What's up guys, this is Balázs from Racing Brick. I still owe you some reviews of the 2020 Technic sets, but there's something I've been working on in the past few weeks, and I'm very happy to share the results with you today. As you know, I'm a big fan of the powered up system and the huge amount of possibilities it can bring to the LEGO RC world, but I also have some concerns regarding the way it is being rolled out. I had high hopes for the app's 3.0 release last December, but unfortunately one of the main issues was still not addressed, and it is the total lack of documentation. I'm sure you know the boost app and you are familiar with the tooltips that you can access on the code blocks with a long press. This might not be the quickest way to access information, but at least it's there and it is very, very useful during the learning process. Compared to the boost app, at the moment this is the sort of help we can get in the powered up app. It is practically nothing. About a month ago I tried to find another way to get information and I reached out to LEGO customer service and asked a few questions regarding the app. I have to emphasize that I only had great experience with the customer service so far. They are always super helpful and responsive. This time I was almost sure that they will not be able to answer my questions directly, since they are not powered up specialists and they are really not expected to be, but I was hoping that they will forward my questions to a team who has the necessary knowledge and expertise. Unfortunately, the answers I received after 2 weeks were not really helpful. Most of my questions were not answered or even understood. And regarding the documentation, they basically said that we need to be creative in the free play area and find out how things work. Well, I think that figuring out all of these might not be trivial for most of us, especially for someone without a coding experience. I truly hope the answer received was not an official statement, maybe only the opinion of a single technician. Connecting an infrared receiver, a battery box and the motor, and then using the infrared remote was pretty intuitive in the power functions era. But the powered up environment requires very different skills and knowledge. Luckily, after a few emails back and forth, the customer service representatives again showed me their commitment and they turned out to be much more helpful than the technical team. They managed to send me a list of the powered up command blocks with some explanation, similar to the one that is available on the webpage for Boost. Unfortunately, the list was incomplete, not updated to the latest app version, and already had some outdated information. So instead of sharing the file as it is, I decided to put some time and effort in the project and I recreated the whole list with all the blocks available currently in the 3.0 version of the powered up app. I used the information from the file but also added my notes and added some examples to most of the blocks to help you with the basic usage. Where can you access it? If you go to racingbrick.com, you might notice previously the powered up menu item there. Before, it took you directly to my powered up page that provides a summary about the whole ecosystem, the basics, available sets, motors, etc. It is still there, but now there's a list opening under powered up. You can access the summary and also the code reference in two versions. The first version is a more simple one with the most important information regarding each block. As you can see, if you open it on your computer, you will see the image of the blocks, the category, the name and the description. You can quickly scroll through the whole list and find the block you are looking for. Then, if you click on the green plus icon next to the block, some additional information will appear. You can see a short code example and a written description. The list has a similar behavior on a mobile device and on tablets as well. The only difference is the amount of information visible initially. As you can see on my phone, the first two columns are visible, so you can identify the block you are looking for. But the rest is also there if you open an item. It works in a similar way on my iPad as well, but with more columns visible by default. The second version can be accessed from this link on the first page or from the menu as well. It has some additional columns that can be useful if you want to know all the details about the code blocks. Since this table is significantly wider, the navigation is a bit different. On a computer, it is advised to show only 5 entries at a time. This way the scroll bar is still visible and you can scroll through the columns. There are some extra options such as the ability to change the visibility of the columns. You can remove the ones that you don't want to see. You can also use the search box that basically works as a filter. I can, for example, enter flow blocks and then it only lists the flow blocks category. On a touchscreen device, you can also extend the list and navigate it, since you can easily scroll vertically and horizontally as well with your finger. The column filtering and the search functions are working here as well. So I really hope you will find this code reference table useful and it will make your life with powered up a little bit easier. This is the initial version of the table, so there might be some bugs here and there, Please let me know if you encounter any issues and I will try to do my best to fix it. Please also feel free to send me updates or suggestions regarding the content. Remember, this is only a code blog guide, so you still need to work on your own programs, but I have some other projects going on for Powered Up, so you can expect other useful things coming soon. If you like this video, then please give it a thumbs up. You can also subscribe and tap the notification bell if you want to see more technique reviews and other LEGO RC videos. See you next time. Bye bye.